Now, what is molecule? Molecule is defined as the smallest unit of matter which has an independent existence and can retain complete physical and chemical properties of the matter. So, from the nature of the molecules, we can get the complete details about the physical and chemical properties of the matter. And we know that atoms combines to form molecule. Here, we know that two hydrogen atoms when combines each other, then it forms a molecule, and this molecule is very stable. We know that the hydrogen atom itself is not stable, but the molecule, hydrogen molecule, is stable. So we can say that molecule is the smallest unit of matter. What is the characteristic of molecule? The molecules are in the state of continuous motion. Always remember that molecules are in the state of continuous motion. Now, it is a big question that why molecules have movement? Molecules move because they have energy in the form of translation, vibration, and rotation. Now, where did this energy come from? Originally, this energy comes from the creation of the universe. You will study it thoroughly in your next classes. Okay, now you need to know that molecules are always in the state of continuous motion. Okay, if we consider that, if we place a drop of perfume in the corner of a closed room, then and if there is no motion of the air in the room, then what will happen? We will observe that after a few minutes, the fragrance of the perfume spreads all over the room. Why this is happening? This is happening because the molecules of the perfume is moving randomly and it is in continuous motion, so that the perfume spreads all over the room. We will study about now arrangement of the molecules in matter or kinetic theory of matter. It is very important. So, the first assumption is that molecules are in a state of continuous motion. We all know that. We have already discussed it. Now, due to this motion, the molecules possess kinetic energy. We all know that any body which has its motion, it possesses kinetic energy. So, molecules also have their continuous motion, so that molecules also possess their kinetic energy. And if we consider only one molecule and if its velocity is v and mass is m, then its kinetic energy should be half mv square. Clear? Now, the second assumption is that the kinetic energy of the molecules increases with the increase in temperature and decreases with the decrease in temperature. That means the kinetic energy of the molecules is directly proportional to the temperature. Why? We know that with increase in temperature, the disturbance of the molecules increases as well as their velocity also increases. So, we know that the kinetic energy of the molecules depends upon the velocity. So, we can say that with increase in velocity, the kinetic energy of the molecules also increases. So, we can say that the kinetic energy of the molecules is directly proportional to the temperature. Now, the third assumption is that the molecules always attract each other. It is very important. The molecules always attract each other. The force of attraction between similar kind of molecules is called force of cohesion, whereas the force of attraction between different kinds of molecules is called force of adhesion. Suppose, if we consider the attraction between two water molecules, then we know that they are similar kind of molecules. So, the force of attraction between them is force of cohesion. But if we consider the attraction between one water molecule and one chlorine molecule, then we know that they are different kind of molecules. So, the force of attraction between them is the force of adhesion. Clear? Now, the fourth assumption is that the empty space between the molecules is called intermolecular space. We know in a matter,
there is a arrangement of molecules. So when the molecules are arranged in a systematic way, then there is a space between the molecules. This space is called intermolecular space. We will study it thoroughly when we will discuss about the arrangement of molecules in solid, liquid and gas. Now, the fifth assumption is that the force of attraction between the molecules is called intermolecular force of attraction. That means both the cohesive force and adhesive force are intermolecular force of attraction. Now, the sixth assumption is that the intermolecular force of attraction decreases if the intermolecular space between the molecules decreases and vice versa. That means when the distance between the molecules is large, then the intermolecular force is small. So this is the kinetic theory of matter, and we have to read it thoroughly. Clear?